And so the government's credibility in this field is pretty damn low. So you can't, they can't come out and say, well, here's the truth today.
In the NASA STS-75 tether incident of March 1996, we find NASA using ultraviolet light-sensitive video cameras. This is where some of the largest UFOs ever caught on videotape have been captured. Huge dish-shaped luminous UFOs swarm the tether. We know the tether is 77 to 100 miles away from the cameras on the shuttle. The UFOs pass behind the 12-mile-long tether, so we can therefore use the 12-mile length of the tether to measure their minimum diameters. Some measure between 1 and 3 miles wide, making them literally motherships.
Key players, the highest levels of power, reaches down to the level of every man, woman, and child.
What's that streak flashing by Earth?
That is simply cannot be a natural object.
Or these discs appearing to pass behind the 12-mile-long orbiting tether.
The UFOs go behind the tether.
And look to the left, that little blip making a high-speed turn. Watch it again.
We're looking at speeds that are beyond anything known to science.
Up top there, that circular image racing away from a space shuttle.
This is suggesting incredible intelligence.
Guys, can you hear me?
Franklin, we see a long line, a couple of star-like things, and a lot of things swimming in the foreground. Can you describe what you're seeing?
Well, the long line is a tether, and there's a little bit of debris that kind of flies with us, and it's illuminated by this.
20 miles now from Columbia.
Guys, getting the image?
Franklin, we see a long line, a couple of star-like things, and a lot of things swimming in the foreground. Can you describe what you're seeing?
Well, the long line is a tether, and there's a little bit of debris that kind of flies with us, and it's illuminated by the stars.
Plot to conceal the truth about the existence of extraterrestrials. It's a global conspiracy, actually. Key players, highest levels of power, and it reaches down to the lives of every man, woman, and child on this planet.
flew into the frame like this, and it shot a beam of light at the warhead. Now, remember, all this stuff is flying at several thousand miles an hour. So this thing fires a beam of light at the warhead, hits it, fires another beam of light, and then flies out the way it came in. And the warhead tumbles out of space. Now, when the lights came on, Major Mansman turned around and looked at me and said, "Were you guys screwing around up there?" And I said, "No, sir." And he said, "What was that?" And I said, "It looks to me like we got a UFO."